So welcome to the video number 1 on integrated circuits. In this session, we'll discuss about the introduction, integrated circuits, definition and its classification, types of ICs based on function, classification of digital ICs, examples for linear and digital ICs, and also the advantages of integrated circuits. To talk about integrated circuits, I'll take one example of television. In 1926, the television was this much bulk, that means it was occupying a space of about 1/4 of a room. But in 1953, the size was little lesser than the previous one because the television circuits mainly made up of active elements like transistors and diodes and passive elements like resistors and capacitors connected together by wires. In the modern television, the circuits are made up of integrated chips, I mean resistors, capacitors, transistors and diodes were replaced by integrated chips. So due to these integrated chips, electronic gadgets were so thin and compact. So these ICs are used to develop calculators, mobiles, laptops and televisions, etc. Now we can see very thin laptops and also the mobile and electronic gadgets. This compactness of electronic devices is possible only by integrated chips. If so, what are integrated chips? Now let's see what is an IC. IC is a single crystal chip of silicon in which active and passive elements are incorporated with an external connecting terminals. And also, we can define in a single word that it is a packaged electronic circuit. So, these ICs can function as amplifier, timer, oscillator and microprocessor. All the arithmetic, logic and memory functions can be performed by a single chip placed on the computer. Small ICs can perform calculations and store data using either digital or analog technology. So based on this, we can classify that into two types, that is digital ICs and analog ICs. So what are digital ICs? Digital ICs work on the basic digital system with two defined levels, that is 0 and 1, or low state or high state. So what is the example for digital ICs? Microprocessor and microcontroller, which contains millions of flip-flops and logic gates, are the examples. So what are the classification of digital ICs based on the gates per chip? So how many gates that integrated chip contains? Based on that, it is classified into small scale integration, where it contains 3 to 30 gates per chip. And the second one is the medium scale integration, where it contains 30 to 300 gates per chip. And the third one is large scale integration, where it contains 300 to 3000 gates per chip. And the fourth one, very large integration, where it contains more than 3000 gates per chip. Now let's come to the linear or analog ICs. These ICs work by processing continuous signals, for example op amp and also the NE555 timer and sensor. So based on the structure, we can classify this into thin and thick film ICs, monolithic ICs and hybrid or multi-chip ICs. First let's discuss thin film ICs. These thin film ICs are formed on the surface of an insulating substrate like glass or ceramic material, on which only the passive elements such as the resistors and capacitors are formed through thin film technique. Afterwards, after the passive elements have been formed, the active elements like transistors and diodes are added as a discrete elements to the surface of the structure. So, what is the thickness of this structure? It will be for about 50 angstrom to 20,000 angstrom, and these type of ICs are used in high power applications. How these films are drawn. These films are grown from either of vacuum evaporation technique or thick film ICs. Silk printing technique is used to create the desired pattern of the circuit on a ceramic substrate. Thick film ICs are sometimes referred to as printed thin film. The screens are actually made of fine stainless steel wire mesh, and connections are made using the paste having the conductive, resistive or dielectric properties. These circuits are fired in a furnace at high temperature to fuse the films to the substrate. Now let's see what are monolithic ICs. The monolithic word derived from the Greek words. Mono means one, lithos means stone. Monolithic circuit is a circuit which built into a single crystal. These are mostly common types of ICs used today. These ICs are cheap and reliable. ICs are used as amplifiers, voltage regulators, in AM receivers and in computer circuits. The third class of ICs are hybrid or multi-chip ICs. More than one individual chips are interconnected. The active components are diffused transistors or diodes. The passive components are diffused resistors or capacitor on a single chip. So these are widely used for high power applications, that is from 5 watt to more than 50 watt. Performance is better than that of the monolithic ICs. If you see the advantages of ICs, one is the miniaturization and the increased system reliability due to the elimination of solid out joints and the improved functional performance. And the next one is the cost reduction, increased operating speeds and reduction in power consumption. All these advantages of ICs can be borne in mind with a mnemonic MRP CSP. Thank you for watching this video.